That's how you make a breakfast burrito, folks. Well, welcome back to an episode of Fishing with Flair. Today, John and I, we're going fishing. These two boys, they're gonna go do slamming and bond sell things. We're gonna go, actually, the goal today, after we eat breakfast, is to go fishing. I know, it's crazy. Haven't fished in a long time. We're going fishing, and we're gonna try to catch some bass at a private pond and transport them to the Brew Bakery. That's the whole goal today. But first, we chefed it all up. We got the breakfast burritos for the whole squad. And I wanna say huge thanks to ButcherBox for sponsoring today's breakfast. If you guys don't know what ButcherBox is, they send meat directly to your doorstep. It's 100% organic. It's grass-fed beef, organic chickens, free-range chickens, the whole nine yards. Everything about ButcherBox is just exactly what you want in meat. You don't want any of the additives or anything like that. So this bacon right here, this was ButcherBox bacon, and if you guys sign up right now, all you gotta do is click the link at the very top of the description. You get $20 off your first box, and you get free bacon for life. Every single box that you get during your subscription, if you sign up right now if you go sign up, you get a free pack of bacon every single month in every single box that you get. So, boys, ready? You gotta taste this. Slam and get some bacon. I'll tell you what, it's the best bacon you ever had. The best bacon.
Thick slices.
Yeah.
Thick
just,
with two
just
C's.
Just amazing.
Thick with two C's? Slamin gave it the thick with two C's, but it's not just about bacon. They got pork, beef, they have salmon, they've got chicken. You pick what you want, they deliver it to your doorstep every single month. It's organic grown. Everything about it is delicious, comes to your door. Like I said, basically you just feast up every single month. Like I said, if you guys want free bacon and $20 off your first box, I'll leave a link down in the description. You guys go check it out. But we are gonna house these little breakfast burritos here, and then we're going fishing. You guys stay tuned. Sick. Johnny!
Hello.
What's happening?
Just editing some videos.
Oh, I said it's happening.
Oh, it's happening. What's happening?
I don't know. Just thought you might get excited if I said that.
I'm excited. I'm aroused.
Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. We are going fishing today. I'm excited. We're actually gonna be fishing with my buddy Felix. You guys haven't seen him in a while. He's been in a few videos. But Felix says, hey, Flair, I got the juice. Take you to the juice. Sorry, right, Felix, I'm on my way. We're going to the juice. The idea today is we're gonna try to stock the Brew Bakery with fish from another pond. So we have access to a private pond, and we brought a cooler filled with water to put the bass in with aerators and all the good stuff. And we're gonna try to go catch some bass and then transport them to the Brew Bakery and then release them. We've talked about stocking the Brew Bakery for the longest time, and now is finally that time. And the reason why we brought water in our cooler is because you can't legally transport water. Fun fact for you guys, if you guys are gonna try to stock a pond or transport fish, you have to take, you can't take lake water from one lake and bring it to another. That's a big no-no. You can't do that. So what we're doing is we brought water. We brought a giant cooler filled with water from the house that we're gonna put the fish in, and that's what we're gonna use to transport the fish. But right now we're about to meet up with Felix. I'm really hoping we catch some big fish, because I wanna stock some biggins. I wanna catch like a 5-pounder, stick in the Brew Bakery and let it eat all the god dang sunfish that are in there. Those things need to be taught a lesson.
Here's another one.
Oh, really? Oh, so it's gonna be one of those days, huh? Got it.
Oh, yeah.
All right, this is gonna work as a makeshift live well. Oh, we can put that guy in there already. There you go. We're gonna stick him in here, and as soon as we catch a few, we're gonna run up to the truck where I've got a giant cooler with water from the house with aerators going. But right now, he'll be fine just sitting in there. We already caught one. I didn't get in the boat. We already caught one. We're off to stock the Brew Bakery. This is mission number. Well, I bought fish. I bought some bass, bought some bluegill. This is like a real mission, fishing mission to stock the Brew Bakery. We've already got one. It's a good sign. But this lake, so the idea behind this lake has stunted bass. So we're gonna take the bass from here to the Brew Bakery and let them flourish and eat the green sunfish and do all that jazz. So it's kind of just like kind of piggybacking off of each pond to, you know, help this lake and help the Brew Bakery at the same time, do some lake management. What are you starting with?
I'm a fluke.
A fluke. I feel like I gotta throw a frog just because. Oh,
sure.
He dropped. Yeah, he just had the. I could see he just had the frog legs. He might need to go to something smaller. Yeah, he just grabbed the little legs. All right, we're making a switcheroo here already. This Texas rig's probably a little too heavy, huh? Here, I bet I could get away with it if I just go lazy and do that. And then it'll have a slower fall, right? I really just don't want to untie, so we're gonna try the Carolina rig approach. You ever see someone do that? They're just like, I don't want to retie, so we're just gonna like move the weight up. There you go. Oh, a little baby guy. That's a flare
that's
fish.
A flare fish.
Yeah.
That's what I've heard.
Yep. That's a baby.
Why?
I don't care. It's up to you guys. We might as well have a few generations.
going through there. I gotta retie. This isn't the deal. I think we're just gonna go with the straight up Stanko. All right, we're moving, or we're not moving, we're changing baits here. All right, I'm re-rigging. We got a stick bait going on here. This is the deal. There's a bite. Oh, does he have it? Oh, he dropped it. That was a little guy.
Biggest fish I caught this week was 5 pounds.
There's a fish.
Look here.
There we go. Get ready to take them.
Shh.
Oh, they're coming in. There we go. My first one. We'll call these green sunfish eaters. That's what we'll call these things. First one in the box for me. Done. They've kept pulling the legs down on it, but I think it's just a little too big for like the size I just caught. Oh, here we go. Go back to back. That's a better one. Come on. Back to back. The stick bait. It's the deal.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I know there's big spawn.
The only problem about S81.
There's one.
It's so stinking hard to.
That's a good one.
Better?
That's a better fish, yeah. Yeah, that's a big fish. That's better. Look at that guy. Look at that. That one, that's a green sunfish eater and a half right there. That's a good one there. Boom, in the bucket he goes. Nice. You guys good?
Felix is hooked up with a biggin.
Looks like
he's pulling dragon. Uh-oh. What do we got?
I don't know. That's a big fish.
Big tank? Oh my gosh, is it big?
I haven't seen him yet.
Oh yeah, that's a nice one.
Really?
Oh yeah.
4 pounder? We can't take those. We gotta put those back. Those are the fish you want in here. You don't want to take those out.
Oh yeah, look at that sucker.
Yeah, you don't want to take those out. Oh my gosh, that's a tank.
Look at that thing.
Oh my gosh.
Hey, Sarge, what do you think of that?
Look how big that fish is.
We won't be keeping this one.
No, we can't keep that one. That's exactly the size you want in a pond. You don't want to take any of those out. All right, we're getting a weight on this fish.
Uh-oh. Almost six.
Really?
No way.
I'll call it a six. It's six. It's 6-0. I'll call that a 6 pounder.
Take that and stick in your pipe there, Mr. Sergeant.
That's a good one. 6 pounder. That's
go
huge.
And make a bigger one. There he goes.
Sheesh. I'm over here catching 1 pounders. Six. I don't think I've seen it. I haven't seen a 6 pounder this year. I haven't been in a boat that's caught a 6 pound bass in 2019. I haven't been in the boat with Felix. That's my problem. I figured out my problem. I haven't been in the boat with Felix.
That day he went.
You got one.
Yep. Shoveled. Oh, hey, look at John.
John got one. About time, Junior.
Yep.
About time. You're on the board.
Giants out.
That's your contribution to the Brew Bakery, huh?
Oh yeah.
Right there, biggins only.
Is there room in that one?
Yep. Toss it in the other bucket.
Toss her in there.
Go ahead.
Little Brew Bakery fish. We got the bubblers going here, plugged into the truck. Got two of these guys. This is again water from home. And this guy, this is the big one that I caught. That's gonna eat some green sunfish. That's actually a really nice bass. Put him in there. So we've got six, and we can legally take 12. So we're halfway done.
Yeah, going full Bill Dance today.
Yeah, this is the move. We gotta start fishing.
Yeah, I gotta start fishing like this. This is way more enjoyable. There you go.
Oh yeah.
Oh, John's hooked up again. Now we're talking. Get him there, boy. That's a perfect little stalker. What happened? You switched to the stick bait. And
switched to the stick bait.
Big things happen.
Just starting to hammer now.
There you go. That's two for you.
Good.
Boom.
I'm watching your video.
There you go. Really? Uh-oh, we're doubled up. We're doubled up. There you go.
We're catching left and right.
Look at that.
Yep.
We got one and two. Coming along nicely, boys. We're going to have the Brute Bakery up and running in no time. Woo! And who made it to the pond, the Brute Bakery. It's looking a little bit of vegetable. Well, you can't see it through freaking the bushes, but there's a lot of weeds. Chemicals, I guess, must take time, or I just got scammed. One of the two. I guess we'll find out. Let's get these bass situated here. Oh, they all made it. Look at all of them. They're live as can be. We got these three aerators, and these were ice packs, actually. They're all good. We got 12 of them in there. Felix and Craig are waiting up on the hill. We didn't want to have to take two trucks down here and tear it off because it's a little bit muddy, but we're going to go ahead and release these guys. 12. 12 of the brewery. So 12 plus 6. 18. That took me way too long to figure out. There's going to be 18 bass in this pond now. Couple little guys. There's a couple. This one's decent. That's a green fish eating son of a gun. That's not a bad one. We can probably catch him later on. These other guys might take some time, but they're not looking too bad. So I guess let's go ahead and just drain this.
And then we're gonna put some of the pond water in here and get them acclimated, and we should be good to go. All right, buddies, come on. We dumped some pond water in here to kind of get them acclimated, so now we're just gonna send them on their way right here. 12 more fish in the Brute Bakery. That's a big one. Look at that guy. Oh, we got a worm. Look at that guy. Yep, he'll eat a chatterbait later. These fish are nice and lively. Last but not least. Boom! We only gotta do that about 10 more freaking times before the Brute Bakery is up and around, but that'll help. Those are some green sunfish eating sons of guns. Well, part one, that's pretty much the entire video. We do have to go check on something before we end the video. Austin and Slayman took the 10 pounder. I was like, guys, go fishing today. We're John and I are fishing. I feel bad. You guys should go fishing. Take my boat and go wherever you want. Go pick a lake and go. And I got a text message, and my boat with the trailer was way off the side of the ramp, and they called me saying they can't get the boat out. I think the 10 pounder might be gone. So
what the hell did you Jimmy's do to the boat?
I should pop up the photo. Do you have it saved?
Oh, we got video of it, everything.
Oh, okay. All right, let's roll the clip. So yeah, that's what these dumbasses did when I said, hey guys, borrow my boat today, go fishing, go have some fun, me and John will go film another video.
We had to teach Sam how to back down a boat. He's never done it before.
And he didn't. This is
a straight shot.
No, this is long. This is a long boat ramp. I'll give him that much. It's long. It's not short. Should I go try to catch a fish real quick or what? All right, let's go. I'm gonna go try to catch one fish before we go. All right, I'm catching a fish. You coming with, John?
Let's see if this thing still floats before I put it back.
All right, we're off. All right, well, we got a Stanko on. So we were catching him on at the other pond. Let's see if this works.
Definitely bash or smirk something back there. There's one.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Phew.
Look at that little dinker. Squeak, squeak, McGee. On the old stick bait. Well, I'm gonna try to catch another one here. Pulled up in this little cut. Figured, hey, the boys were like, hey, you need to come rescue us from this lake. We don't know what we're doing. We don't want to put the boat back on the trailer because they could barely launch it, which is the easy part. So I came here to rescue them. So I said, hey, my boat's already in the water. Let's catch some fish. I got a bite. I can tell by watching my line.
Yo.
You.
I didn't even feel him. Watching the line. Take notes, folks. If you throw in there with a weightless bait, and all of a sudden your line started zipping off, it ain't your bait, it's a fish. That's fish number two. I don't wanna, you know, pound up on these fish too bad. I feel like I should come back and make a fishing video someday here. It's not a bad little honey hole here. I don't think I've ever been to this lake. A little squeak, squeak, McGee. But I say let's get the boat back on the trailer and we'll see what happens next.
Jeez.
Yeah, just pull. Yep. See, this is what happens when they mess up the boat. Make them put it on the trailer. They can get wet, not me. You're doing great. Good job, kiddos. All right, let's go get lunch for everybody.
Ooh. We're on this one.
Let's go for it.
Look at these guys.
Dude.
You cannot say that.
Bro, some grease just got on me and burned me out of my hand. I mean bad.
All right, we gotta wait like a really long time.
Yeah.
All right, we'll be back in like 10 minutes. I gotta ice my hand down. Literally grease dripped on it and just singed the entire side of my pinky. All right, it's somewhat cooled down.
I don't know how I'm gonna do in this, to be honest.
Get your meat. Wow. See this piece of breading? Stick that breading right on your fork and get whatever the hell this is. Oh yeah, these are frog legs, by the way. Mmm. That tastes like chicken. Those are like a million times better than ours, though.
Why is this so big?
So, the other thing I got, this is a power move. Two grilled cheese sandwiches. See, there's one grilled cheese, two grilled cheese, and then they put barbecue brisket in between.
Whose mans is out here doing this?
Oh, that should be illegal.
Woo! Well, folks, made it back from lunch. We're down at the farm now. Drove a couple hours. We are at the farm to film another video, but that's not today's video. If you guys enjoyed today's video, let me know in the comment section down below. We stock the Brew Baker. If you guys have any better ideas how to stock it, let me know. I feel like this is probably just the best way. Slowly but surely, go take fish out of ponds that are overstocked with stunted bass and put them in ours. And hopes that they don't get stunted and they start growing, they start eating green sunfish. That's the plan, at least. Like I said, if you guys enjoyed this video, let me know in the comment section down below. I really do appreciate the view. Peace.